Hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of our bitwise logical operators in Go lesson. Let's continue with the bitwise logical operators. The next operator we have is the XOR operator, also represented with a caret sign. The XOR operator, represented by a caret symbol, sets the resultant bit if one bit is set and the other is not, or if one bit is 1 and the other bit is 0. Let's refer to the same table once again. In the first row, we have 0, 0 for both bits. The XOR operation will result in 0 as both bits are the same. In the second row, when the first bit is 0, the second bit is 1, or vice versa, the XOR operation will yield 1 as one bit is set while the other one is not. So same is the case with next one, where we have one bit set and the other bit is not, resulting in a 1. The fourth row represents a case where both bits are 1 and 1. The XOR operation will result in a 0 as both bits are same. By examining the table here, we can understand the outcomes of XOR operation for various combination of two bits. So to summarize, XOR operator sets the resultant bit if one bit is set and the other bit is not, or in simple language, it sets the resultant bit if one bit is 1 and the other is 0. Now let's perform the XOR operation between two binary numbers bit by bit. For the leftmost bit, or the most significant bit, we have 1 in A and 1 in B. Since both bits are the same, or both bits are set, the XOR operation will yield 0. Moving on to the second leftmost bit, we have 1 in A, 0 in B. Here one bit is set and the other bit is not, therefore the XOR operation will yield 1. Next we have 0, 0, since no bit is set, result is 0. Again we have 0, 0, result is 0. Next we have 1 and 1, since both bits are set, the result is 0. Next we have 0 and 1, since only one bit is set while the other one is unset, the result is 1. Next we have 1, 0, again only one bit is set, the result is 1. Next we have 0, 1, again only one bit is set, the result is 1. So after performing the XOR operation on each corresponding pair of bits, the resultant binary number is 01000111, or decimal 71. Next we have the AND-NOT operator, represented by an ampersand sign and a caret sign. The AND-NOT operator sets the resultant bit if the corresponding bit is set in the first number but not in the second number. So it is important to note that the order of operation is significant here. Here we refer to the table again. The first number is A while the second is B. First we have the case of 0, 0. Since we don't have the bit set in A, the result will be 0. Again we have 0, 1. Again, bit is not set in the first number, so we can say the result is 0. Next, we have 1, 0. Since the bit is set in the first number but not in the second, the result is 1. Next, we have 1, 1. Since the bit is set in both the numbers, the result will be 0. To summarize, the AND-NOT operator sets the resultant bit if the bit is set in the first number but not in the second. Again, important to remember, the order matters. It is also known as a bit clear operation. Now let's perform the AND-NOT operation between two binary numbers bit by bit. For the leftmost bit, we have 1 and 1 in both A and B. The AND-NOT operation sets the resultant bit to 1 if corresponding bit is set in the first number but not in the second number. In this case, both the bits are set, so AND-NOT operation will yield 0. Next, we have 1 in A, 0 in B. Here the corresponding bit in A is set, but the corresponding bit in B is not set. Therefore, AND-NOT operation will yield a 1. Next, we have 0 in A and 0 in B. Since the bit is not set in the first number, we can straight away say the resultant bit will be 1. Next, we have 0, 0 again, so the result will be 0. Next, we have 1, 1. The bit is set in the first number, but it is also set in the second number, so we can say the result is 0. Next, we have 0, 1. Again, bit is not set in first, we can say 0. Next, we have 1, 0. Bit is set in the first number, but it is not set in the second. The result will be 1. Again, the bit is not set in the first number, so the result will be 0. After performing the AND-NOT operation on each corresponding pair of bits, the resultant binary number is 01000010, or decimal 66. Next, we have the INVERT operator. The caret symbol serves as a binary operator when placed between two numbers performing the XOR operation. However, when used as a unary operator with a single number, it executes the INVERT operation. As the name implies, the INVERT operation flips the bit in place. If bit is initially set to 0, the invert operation will set it to 1, and if bit is set to 1, the invert operation will set it to 0. So in summary, caret operator, when used as a unary operator, works as an invert operator. The invert operation inverts the state of bit 0 becomes 1 and 1 becomes 0. It is also known as the NOT operator. So now it's time for example once again. The invert operation is written as caret sign and the number or A. Let's examine the operation on each bit of A. The leftmost bit or most significant bit is set to 1. After the invert operation, it becomes 0. Next, we have 1. It becomes 0 again. Next, we have 0. It becomes 1. 0 becomes 1. 1 becomes 0. 0 becomes 1, 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1. So after applying the invert operation on the binary number A, which was 11001010, we get the resultant binary number 00110101 or decimal 53. Each 0 in the original number becomes 1 and each 1 becomes a 0 in the final result. That's it for the lesson. In this lesson, we covered bitwise logical operators available to us in Go. In the next lesson, we will practice bitwise logical operation with code. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you have any questions, please reach out to our Discord server or leave a comment under the video. I will see you in the next lesson. Happy coding!